Hey YouTubers, 95 speed GTA. As promised, those cars that you guys saw that I had, my customers' cars that I'll be doing, I will be making a video on each one. So tonight, we're gonna be working on taking off the front bumper cover on this 2003 Volkswagen Passat. I think this video can go for 1998 to I think 2003 Passats. Pretty sure that's how it goes. But anyway, let me take you off camera and show you why we're replacing this bumper. Okay. So, it looks pretty good until we get to the bottom. The customer had an accident, and what really sucks about this is the bumper itself is in good shape. The only thing that's not in good shape is right below the license plate bracket. These little supports, they're busted off. Now, sometimes people, they could plastic weld them back together. But as you can see, this has been broken for a really long time. So the whole bumper is warped here on the bottom. And not for anything, I'm not gonna take the chance of, well, I don't even have a plastic welder, of plastic welding it and just having the bottom part of the bumper out of round and putting that centerpiece, the center grill piece, in the middle and take the risk of having it falling out. Another thing that I realized about this Passat is this bumper comes in more than one piece. And here's what I mean. You got this lower deflector, which I went to the Volkswagen dealer and they gave me the wrong year. So I gotta go back there and hopefully they have the right one in stock. Probably not. But I gotta grab that. And I gotta transfer the grill. This is another piece. So keep this in mind if you go ahead and you wanna get a new bumper for your car. This piece right here, in between the bottom of the bumper and the headlights, this is actually a separate piece from the bumper. And you gotta make sure that you take that out and transfer it to, you know, the other car. I'm sorry, the other bumper. The license plate frame, the other piece, the turn signal, and I want to show you, if you buy a new bumper, I'm gonna put you guys back up on the pedestal. Just want to show you guys something about these bumpers. It's not like a 1-2-3 deal. You actually, depending on how hard your car was hit, depends on how many parts you need to buy. I needed to buy the bumper, I needed to buy the lower grill, and now I'm gonna have to buy that wind deflector. But here's how the bumper comes. Now, I need to contact the company that I use to buy my bumpers. This is a pre-painted part. You give them a call and you give them the paint color code of your car, and they paint the bumper and they ship it out to you. So this is how it comes. It comes, as you see, without that middle piece on both sides, without the bottom piece, and absolutely no hardware. And I think that the most challenging thing on doing this bumper replacement is getting the, you know, if you live in a state that requires two license plates on your car. I think the hardest part, really, and I'm kind of joking a little bit about this, is actually drilling for the license plate holes. There's actually on the back of the bumper, let me show you guys, on the back of the bumper, there's no pilot holes or anything. Like when I did the front bumper on my 2008 Nissan Altima, it actually had like molding pieces on the back just to, like, I guess, to guide you. But remember, if you're replacing a bumper on your 2003 Passat, and I want to say any German car, be prepared. Depending on the extent of damage that you have, depends on how many parts you need to buy. So the bumper is one part. The middle chrome filler panels are two other parts. The grill is another part. And some of these cars actually came with headlight washer nozzles inside the bumper. So said and done, you could be looking at the bumper but six other parts. So just consider this a painted shell. And if you get lucky like I did, you could transfer all the parts over except for the lower deflector and the grill. Because really, that's the only thing that was really damaged on this bumper. And it kind of sucks that we got to replace it. But hey, we got to replace it. That's what the car is here for, and that's what the customer's paying me for. So I started yesterday just messing around a little bit, and I stopped because I remembered I promised that I would do videos again. And I started taking off these Torx. You can forget about this German car, you can forget about using a Phillips head screwdriver for a lot of stuff. Almost everything is Torx on this. So this is what I'm using. I don't know if you guys could see that. HW4. It's like an Allen key. Allen key Torx. This is gonna be, we're gonna start taking the grill off first, so there's gonna be one of those in there. Get yourself a magnetic tray. This thing works the best. Oh wait, I lied. We do have some Phillips head screws, and take a guess what these are from. They're from the license plate cover. So we're gonna put this off to the side, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna work on getting the grill out. So we're gonna have another one on this side, and it looks like we got two Torx in the middle. I don't think that has anything to do with the grill and the bumper, so we're gonna leave that alone. And now I'm gonna go get my tool, and we're gonna pry the bumper out, because it looks like the only thing, I'm sorry, pry the grill out, because it looks like the only thing that's holding in the grill are those press clips. So I can show you a cool tool to buy. You can find them online. I mainly use these for interior work, and I think in a couple of other my videos I've showed you these tools. But if you go online, you can get a whole set of them. Look up interior door panel removal tools. They're not just for the door panel. This is actually for the door panel. But you could use these for like a bunch of different other things. Now when you use these, you want to be really careful, because this is sharp metal. And if you're not, if you're reusing the bumper and you just need to take the grill off or whatever, be really careful with these. Another suggestion that I have, which I really forgot for a second that I had, they're the same things, but they're made out of plastic. And you might be better off using these, because these aren't going to damage the paint. In my situation, it really doesn't matter, because that bumper is garbage. So I can use the metal ones. So enough talking. Let's try to get this guy out now. This is the first time of me working on one of these cars. So check inside the grill. Be really careful. Really, really careful getting this out. If we're not careful, we'll be buying a grill for the customer too. Okay, right up on top here is some kind of a retainer holding it in. I'm gonna push it down so we can get this guy out. This looks like the original grill to the car, so I'm gonna be extra careful, because it feels like it's brittled a little bit. It kind of makes me nervous. You see I'm doing it with my fingers. Let me get a light back there so you can see what's going on. All right, so the first thing you want to do is you want to take off this, you want to take off this cover piece. Let me bring you guys up. Alright, so the first thing you want to do to get this grill off is you want to take off this back cover piece you're going to find right here. It's actually held in by two rivets, and they're pretty much pop rivets, and all you do is, how it's supposed to work, is right at the end of it is going to be the rivet, and you can pop it up. But it was broken on this side, and this one was broken too. You know, like I said, this is a customer's car, and I do know that this car has been hit in the front, and it has had its bumper replaced before. So I'm going to say I'm going to blame it on the body shop for them just ripping it up. But we'll fix it. We'll either put new rivets in or screws, whatever we got to do. And yes, this is a turbo motor. Okay, so here's where we're working. Working right here. And if you could see, the mechanism is right here. We got to disconnect that. So we got to disconnect this mechanism so we can get the grill off the car. And there's a little retainer there that we got to pull up really carefully, which I just did now. Now would be a good time to grab a pair of needle nose pliers, or maybe one of those magnets, and pick that thing up, because it's loose right now, and it looks like if you do not do that, it will be lost inside the car forever. So here's a retainer you got to pull up. It's swinging all the way back there, but you'll see. You see that going in and out right there? Let me hold. Hang on 1 second. All right. Here's the retainer. Well, here's the mechanism going in and out. Here's our little retainer that's right here. Okay? That just flops back. So flop it back just like that. And grab your needle nose or flathead, whatever you got handy. And basically, what we got to do is we got to pull this off to the side so it's not in our way anymore. Which I almost got it separated. I got to bring the camera back for a sec. Alright, so this is a little plastic thing. Take your needle nose pliers. What we're going to do is it's basically a fork, and I gotta back up. Hold on 1 sec. All right, so basically what we're doing here is we got a fork that looks like this, and we have to take our needle nose pliers, and we have to separate it like that and pull the hood release out. And once I get this out of the way, I'll show you. This is another thing that looks like it'll break real easily. Oops, almost had it. I really shouldn't say oops while doing this video. So, spread it. Got it. Okay. Once we spread it, pull back slowly. Now I'm going to show you what I was talking about. See how it's like that? Alright, this is your hood release. What you got to do is put a flathead screwdriver in this way and then twist it and then pull back, or use the needle nose just like I did, because it sits on like a barrel. It sits on a pin, actually. And once you move the retainer that's on top of it, it's going to go like that, the retainer, like this. And then you stick your object in there, needle nose or flathead, and you spread it. So these, see what I mean, will come out like that. You pull back. Now we can get the grill off. And put this off to the side. Be very, very careful, because this is all plastic parts, and I'm pretty sure it could all brittle real easily. Oh, look at that. Look how much play we got now. Okay, so now we got the grill off. Here are these clips I was telling you about. These are on the bottom of the grill, and what you got to do is you got to squeeze them. You got to squeeze them or push them forward to get them to compress, and while you're squeezing them, you got to pull up on the grill. Another thing you have to be really, really careful about. See what they look like? That's what they look like. That's what they look like. So now we'll put this off to the side.
In my case, put it up on that nice big cowl panel.
Next on the list, we have
1, 2, 3, 4 bolts. Two of these are star bits. Two of them look like two 10 millimeter bolts. So we're gonna take that off right now. I'm actually going to use these hole lines. Traditionally, right after this, we're going to have one bolt holding the bumper on that side and another one on the other side. They're usually found right here, and there's usually a service hole for them, which I actually got my finger on it. I could feel the hole for it, and it feels like a 10 mil. Just double check to make sure that's right. And it's not. It's actually smaller. Let's try an 8. See, when I did my brother's 2006 Altima, which I did in video, there were two 10 millimeter bolts on each side. Yep, it's an 8.
Alright, so here we are by the wheel well. We got this loose. But now we have some Phillips head screws running down the bottom part here. You may want to start your car and turn the wheel all the way to the left. Or if you got a short enough screwdriver, basically just get in there and turn it out. Power steering leak. Some with the power steering lines. So, grabbing my other little bullshit drill gun. I'm gonna put a light there so we guys can see what's going on. Hope you guys can see. Now this is coming out, no problem. See how we got that? We got the whole side coming now. But we gotta get the bottom. And take a look at that. I'll show you guys once I take the bumper off. All the AC lines are running right there. All you need is one good accident, and that is the end. That is the end of your AC system. I'm pretty sure it's costly to replace. So this is where we're at right now. The whole bumper is ready to come out. We just have to disconnect it from the bottom. Oh, cold. Oh. It's one. The second one's gonna be right here, but it's missing. Next one's right here. That's a long one. And then there's gonna be another one right here, but that one's missing too. So we only had two bolts on the bottom. And let's see what else it's attached to. That's it for that. So before you do what I did, make sure that you take those bolts on the other side of the wheel well off before you jack it up, because now I'm not gonna bring the car down, but it's gonna be a little more difficult. So the only thing that's keeping us from getting this bumper off right now
is those couple of bolts over by the wheel well, like I did on the other side. So we're going to take those off. We're going to pull the bumper off. Hopefully. Do you want to know what the funny part is? I just went to go remove those bolts on the other side of the inner fender. And now that side is Phillips. Oh, God. This is what was in the other side of the fender well that holds the bumper on. And remember, that bolt that actually goes upwards that holds the bumper onto the fender, well, that's one of these too. Strange. So I guess it's safe to say that it's always good to have an array of tools with you when you're working on a used car, especially if you know it's had pre-existing body damage. Because, let me tell you, I'm having a blast switching tools every 5 minutes. Okay, everything seems to be out. Wow, look at that, nice and easy. Then, bumper's out, hold it up. We gotta take the marker lights out. We got scotch tape holding on the marker light on this side, which I have a feeling the reason why that is. Okay. Show you guys real quick. Here's the side marker lights. They actually pop out just like this. So if they're in there, you push this in. You go like, and you go forward with it, because on the other side you'll see two legs holding it in, so you just push it in that direction. When you want to take this out, all you do is put your hand on it like this and pull out, and it pops right out. Put these off to the side for the new bumper. And she's out. Now before we throw this bumper out, like I said, there's things that we have to take off of it. This lower valance or whatever the hell, we can't save because it's busted right here. Oh, actually, wait, maybe we can fix that. I'll try it. I doubt it, but we'll try it. And we gotta reference those license plate holes. This we gotta take out. Other than that, let me move this off. There's our new bumper right there. Indigo blue. Which actually, under the lights, these type of lights, these look like two entirely different color bumpers, or like shades of blue. Which is kind of scary, but if you put natural light on it, like a regular incandescent bulb, well, you bring it out in the daylight, they're the same. It's just off a little bit. And that's expected, because remember, this is a 2003. So if this was the original bumper, which I know it's not, sometimes you'll get color fade. And that's why some body shops, they'll blend it in to match the rest of the panels. Or they'll actually paint it a different color to actually match the rest of the car. So, and this is what they did for the new bumper. They did exactly that. You see how this thing's got to be polished? It's got all, you know, wet contamination marks all over it. I got to clean that after it gets on the car. But the place that I use, they do exactly that. And actually, actually looks pretty good. I like that. This is a little comparison with paintwork. Cool. Alright, so that's how you take the bumper off. I don't know if I should make another video on the installation. It's kind of self-explanatory. But here's what I was saying about the AC lines. Take a look at that crap. It's all right here. Kind of out in the open. So now that we got the bumper off, we're going to get everything packed up. My ass is going home. And we got to work on taking off the parts. We got to get the right lower grill. Meaning the correct lower grill for our car. And then we put it back on. So this concludes how to take off the bumper of your 2003 Volkswagen Passat. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm guessing some of you guys are wondering how to get these side pieces off. These right here. Well, they're a little challenging. And I already took one off already. Let me get you a good shot over here. There we go. Alright, I got one off already. And like I said, it's a little challenging. But I took this off the bumper so I could show you guys. You're gonna see behind the bumper this reinforcement piece. It's got two pieces that actually hold the bumper to the fender. And what you want to get off, that's garbage. What you want to get off is this, to reuse it for the next bumper. And this is 1, 2, 3 pieces. You got your chrome piece, then you got your plastic piece, that's the color of the vehicle, and then you got this. And just in case these fall out, these are little clips to hold it into the bumper. I'll show you guys how to fix that. It's really simple. There's supposed to be a spring in here, but the way it's wedged in there, it kind of goes like this, and the spring holds it up just like so. So this is what it looks like. Make sure you got these clips. You're supposed to have two on each side. There's one broken off here. I didn't do it. But I guess the previous body man that did it broke it. And then you have another set of those clips right here. Then you got these. These are just snap fittings. And what you do is you compress them in and push them out. But they continue from here all the way to the end. Now, I'll show you how to get these out. It's pretty simple. You have to start not from this end where the side marker light is. You got to start from the other end where the front of the bumper is. You have to start here first, because if you start here first, this is probably why this one broke, because they popped it out wrong. In the end, just straighten out the camera. In the end, this is how it's supposed to come out. Like, let's say this is on the bumper. You're supposed to go like this and then pull it out. That's how you're supposed to do it. And that keeps these guys from breaking and bending and, you know, just not being right anymore. So let's flip the bumper over and take a look. All right, so we're working with this side now, and the tools that I used are these two pick tools and a pair of pliers. So like I said, we're gonna start from here. Now, this bracket piece, it comes off. It's a little difficult to get off. I don't think you're supposed to take it off, but I took mine off anyway because the bumper was junk.
and I needed to educate myself on how to use, you know, how to remove this, because I've never taken one off before. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to pop these out without removing this thing, because the new bumper came with this, and it's already pretty much like plastic welded on. So that kind of tells me it's not meant to come off. But then again, who really, you know, who knows? So let's just try it this way and see what happens. So here's the clip, okay? Here's the actual part. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna push it in like so, and then push down. Okay, so that's one. Then this one, same deal, push it in and push down. It looks like it's loose already. Okay. Now we got this next one here. Let me see if I can zoom. Sure you guys can see. We got this next one here. And as you see, it's got like a little stopper right here. So what we gotta do, we gotta push it in, and then while we're pushing in, we push it down. Oops. We push it down so it's not hanging up on this anymore. Then we got the same deal on another one right here. These get a little confusing, I'm just gonna tell you now. Just with all the black plastic. Okay, we got that. We got one more right here. This one, take a look, watch. Push it in. There we go. I'm gonna be really, really careful. Now this is the old bumper, so we're not using it anymore. So we could take our tool and we could pry on the edges like this, because this bumper is going in the garbage. The only thing is, we don't want to harm this in any way, even though it's got a couple of scratches on it or whatever. That I could polish, you know, I could take those out. But cracks, I can't take out. See how it's coming up? Okay. Now you're gonna take your hands, go down like this, and slowly work it up. Slowly work it up. Okay. Now that's it. Once you get about right here, that's as far as you're gonna go with prying. Then we're gonna grab it and we're gonna pull it. See how it moved? And it's out. No harm done. No damage. That's how you do it. You gotta have a lot of patience with doing this. Alright, now that we got the almost everything we need. Well, pretty much we got everything we need. We got pretty much everything we need off this bumper. It's pretty much scrap now. The only thing that I would take off if we were using would be this thing. This panel is called the lower valance, and the only reason why I'm leaving it on and not taking it off is because it's cracked and broken. I can't use it. I can't use it at all. But I will show you guys how to take it off in case you don't have that problem. Basically, it works the same. It works the same as we just did with the with those inner bumper panels. They have all along the pretty
pretty much to get this lower valance cover off, it's the same process as those inner, as the inner bumper pieces. All it's held in by are these little pieces. See them? And all you really have to do is just push them out. You see what I just did right there? Let me show you. Push it, and they come out. It's kind of hard to do. This bumper is so huge. Right here, all around. You gotta pop them off, and in the end, right here, is a rivet. And that you gotta drill out or knock out on your own and replace it with a nut and bolt. Also, if this fender, the bumper's junk, make sure you take all of these. These are the nuts, the little stampings that the screws screw into on the fender well. So just make sure you take all hardware off the bumper. But other than that, this bumper's trash. We got everything we need off of it. So now we can get rid of it. The lower valance, that's staying with the bumper because I ordered a new one. That should be in any day. So now let's get to work on the new bumper. All right, so we're down to switching everything over to the new bumper. And here we are. Old bumper up front, new bumper on the in the bottom. So the only thing, again, the only thing that this bumper is missing is the bottom valance cover, which is this. That's why this is sitting differently. But before I do that, I'm gonna show you guys, just in case, let me make sure you guys can see. But before we do that, I'm gonna show you guys how to put this guy in, which is a side marker light, just in case yours popped out. Okay. This is how it's set up. You get your spring. I'm gonna take it apart so you guys can see. Okay. So, we got our clip. We got our spring. What we're gonna do, we're gonna take this clip, the bottom side of the clip has a hole in it. Not a hole, but just an indentation for the spring. So it's gonna look like this. It's gonna go in the bottom. Like that. Make sure you line up that center tab inside. Now you're gonna take the spring. Put it in sideways like this. Gonna compress the spring. And it goes right in. That's how you do it. Now, put this guy back in. Goes this way. Now take a look at this. See how there's nothing here? See how there's something here? There's supposed to be two little legs that stick out of this. And if you have your legs broken like this, this is always gonna pop out. I don't know if you can see the tape on this, but when the customer dropped the car off, I noticed that, and it's been broken ever since. You're gonna have to order a new one. Or at least take advantage
and wedge it in there and glue it. But then again, if you glue it and this light goes, it's going to be very difficult to get out. So with that in mind, what we do is we put this in first, and those two legs are supposed to go in here. And that's how it's supposed to go in. This part presses up against that plastic inner frame that I was showing you guys before. So it's gonna look like this when you put it in, but now just remember, this is gonna be a little different because the back legs are missing on this one. So I'm gonna have to figure something out, because this always pops out for the customer. So as you can see the tape. He had it taped. I really don't want to tape it again. So maybe I'm going to apply some hot glue here. Nothing too permanent, because I'm not delivering the car with tape on it. But anyway, that's how it goes in. And as I said, this spring-loaded piece, this goes up against that frame piece that you saw that go in here. As you can see, this bumper, this is the old bumper. 1, 2, 3, 4. You go to this bumper, you got 1, 2, and nothing on the bottom. It's not the wrong bumper, but take a look. See that? Grab your pick tool and just punch it through. This happens sometimes. I gotta get the other one.